Hello everyone. Welcome to this video on how to load a report from the Bold Reports report server in a React application. Before getting into the steps, let's take a look at the Bold Report server. Bold Report server is a report management studio provided by SyncFusion, which allows the user to create, manage, and share reports securely and easily. Our report server provides the built-in REST API service that helps you to display the server reports. In this video, I will show you the steps to create a React application and load an already published SSRS RDL report from our report server to the React application. Before getting into the video, make sure your development environment includes Node.js, version 8 or higher, and NPM, version 3 or higher. First, let's see how to generate a personal access token from the report server. To generate a personal token, you need to log into our Bold Reports report server. You will see the list of reports that are published to the report server. Click the user emoji icon from the left navigation bar to generate the personal access token key. Then click the user profile. You will be redirected to the My Profile page. Click the personal access token on the top panel. In the personal access token page, click the Generate Token button. A confirmation dialog is displayed to generate the personal access token. Click the Yes button. You will see the bearer token displayed in the authentication token text box. Click the Click to Copy button to copy the generated access token. Next, I will show you how to install the Create React app. The Create React app is a simple way to create a single-page React application that provides a build setup with no configuration. I run this command to install the Create React app globally in the command prompt. Now, let's create a new React application. To create a new React application, I run this command in the command prompt. The Create React app command adds the React, React DOM, React scripts, and other dependencies required to create a React application. Next, I'll install the Create React class package. I change the directory to the application's root folder by entering this command. To install the type definitions for Create React class, I run this command in the command prompt. The package should be installed as a dev dependency. Next, I'll install the Bold Reports React package. To install the Bold Reports React package, I run this command in the command prompt. To this, I add the script reference. Bold Reports needs a window.jQuery object to render the React components. Open the React application root folder in Visual Studio Code. I am using Visual Studio Code for editing purposes. I create a new file and name it globals.js in the SRC folder. Import jQuery in globals.js file. I then reference the globals.js file in the index.js file. Next, let's refer the necessary scripts in the React application. Open the index.html file from the public folder and reference the scripts in the head tag. I have listed the purpose of each script in the following table. ej2base.min.js, ej2data.min.js, ej2pdfexport.min.js, and ej2svgbasemin.js are used to render gauge items. ej2linearGauge.min.js renders linear gauge report items. ej2circularGauge.min.js renders circular gauge report items. ej2maps.min.js renders map report items. Next, add the report viewer control. I open the app.js file from the SRC folder. I import the necessary script files to render the report viewer control. The bold.reportviewer.min file is imported for rendering the report viewer control. Bold.reports.all.min.css includes the UI theme for the JavaScript reporting control. ej.bulletgraph.min and edge.chart.min files are imported for rendering bullet graph and chart report items in the report viewer control. Viewer style is an object used to store the width and height of the report viewer control. The app function will return the report viewer component. The ID attribute specifies a unique name for the report viewer component. For this demo, I assign the value as report viewer container for the ID attribute. Now, let's configure the report server in the React application to render the report. Inside the bold report viewer component, I enter the report service URL. The report service URL contains the server name, service name, and REST API name. The format of the report service URL is http://reportserver:\reporting/reportService/API/viewer. In this demo, I have hosted the report server in my local machine. So, I have mentioned the report server name as localhost along with the port number in which I have hosted. You can use your own report server name. Reporting/reportService represents the service name of the report server. API/viewer represents the web API name of the report server. Then I enter the report server URL. Report server URL is a variable used to store the report server URL. The format of the report server URL is http://reportserver:\reporting/API/site/site name. In this demo, I have mentioned the report server name as localhost along with the port number in which it is hosted. You can use your own report server name. Site/site1 represents the site from which the report in the report viewer control is to be loaded. As I have kept my report in site1, I have mentioned site/site1. You can mention your own site name. Then enter the service authorization token. The service authorization token specifies the personal authorization token, which is already copied from the report server. Then assign the value for the report path. The report path specifies the path in which the RDL report file is published in the report server. Here I am using Sales Order Details RDL report from the local server location. This report is published in the Sample Reports category. Save the file. Now, let me run the application. I open the command prompt and run this command. It will launch the application in the default browser of the URL. As you can see, the Sales Order Detail report is loaded in the Bold Report Viewer. The Bold Reports team has also documented the steps for loading the report from the Cloud Report Server. The steps that need to be followed are the same, but only the report service URL and the report server URL will differ based on your cloud server configuration. I have shared our cloud reporting sample report service URL and report server URL in the presentation. As the service for the cloud reporting is hosted separately, the reporting/report service is not mentioned in the report service URL. And as multi-tenancy is not supported in the cloud reporting server, the site information is not required in the report server URL. You also need to generate the service authorization token from the cloud report server, as well as the path of the report needed to render it in the report viewer. I have provided the documentation link in the video's description for your convenience. In this video, I showed you how to embed a sample report from report server in a React application using the report viewer control. Stay tuned to this channel for our upcoming videos on bold reports. Don't forget to click the like button and subscribe to our channel. Thanks for watching, and we'll see you next time.